First of all, a podcast takes a lot of work, okay? You have to organize the guests, you have to do a Google Calendar, and you build a following. It takes a long fucking time, and I've been working on it for a while.
Hello, podcasters. Welcome back, or welcome to I Don't Care the Podcast. I'm your girl, Alexia DiStefano. Welcome, everyone. My hair is curly. I just got out of the shower and I diffused it a little bit. Literally just did that. So it's a little crazy right now, but it'll tame out a little bit and look cute. I'm trying to do the more, let my curls out a little bit. It's a lot of fucking work. And I am not some, oh, my dog is trying to get my stickers. Luna, you brought toys down so you don't play with my things. I don't like to do anything with my hair. I sort of just like to get out of the shower, blow dry the top of my head, because that's what gets greasiest fast when I don't. And then I usually call it a day. And my curls do come out when I do that. But this is like, you know, getting them more even and looking better, but it's just so much fucking work. Like, you think I want to diffuse my hair after I just scrubbed it in the shower? On top of it, like, my blow dryer a while ago blew up, and so I've been using my brother's since that happened, and my diffuser head doesn't fit onto his blow dryer. So I've just been like holding the diffuser with my heated glove and separately holding the blow dryer and been doing that. And that's a lot of fucking work. And that takes so much energy. So I asked for Christmas a new blow dryer that comes with the diffuser head. And my brother got it for me and he goes, here, wrap it. So I wrapped it. And I'm kind of annoyed because I should have just taken out the blow dryer and then wrapped the box so I could have been using the blow dryer. I just got cut off. But speaking of things I asked for Christmas, I also asked for an USD card, which I hope I really do get, or multiples, because this one is driving me nuts. So when I delete things off of the SD card from my computer, it doesn't actually delete the storage and the space on the SD card. So if I delete an hour-long episode I'm removing the files from the SD card and putting them into the trash can on my computer, the storage wasted is not deleted on the SD card. And it's taken me a long time to figure that out. And just out of habit, I drag and delete the files. And then I'm like, fuck, I'm gonna need a new SD card soon because that's not actually removing the space. I have to manually delete everything from the camera. I don't know if that's like right, but that's what it is. So this SD card is running out of storage. It doesn't have much left. I just got a random text from a recruiter looking to employ me part-time. It's probably a scam. So I don't have much storage left on this SD card. I just had to get up and delete last week's episode. There was only 3 videos to delete. So that means like every episode until I get one might have to be shorter because it could cut me off at any given moment. And I might not even say goodbye. Which is a fucking annoying. But it is what it is. So that's just my little updates on technology. Let's get into our advice segment, our listen, bitch, advice, affirmation, cards. I'm going to shuffle them up. It's crazy because I feel the card deck getting thinner and thinner every time we do it. And I kind of like how it's almost every time I pull a card, it's almost destiny that I pulled it because it fits sort of how I'm feeling or the mood or tone of my life. So let's see what this one says. Listen, bitch, sometimes letting go is the best way to free yourself. With a little B illustration. I like that. Listen, bitch, sometimes letting go is the best way for you to free yourself. This, for every single person, could mean a multitude of different things. Initially, when I hear this, sort of what I think of when I relate it to my own life is I have the tendency, and that's putting it lightly, to be a perfectionist. Everything needs to be a certain way or my heart starts to race. Everything needs to look the way I want it to look or I'm thinking about it constantly. And, you know, the things that I can control and do have power over, great. I get to do it exactly the way I want to do it. My dog, Luna, she's got something she shouldn't have. I can tell by the way she's looking. What do you got, Luna? Show me. What do you got, guys? Pause. I got a mother.
We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Layback Living is a furniture store that has been providing customers with high quality and stylish furniture for years. They offer a wide selection of furniture for every room in the house, from the living room to the bedroom to the dining room and more. At Layback Living, customers can find furniture that not only looks great, but is comfortable and functional. At Layback Living, quality is their top priority. They only source furniture from trusted manufacturers and personally select each item to ensure that it meets their high standards. Their knowledgeable staff is always available to assist customers in finding the perfect furniture pieces to fit their unique style and needs. With their exceptional customer service and commitment to quality, Layback Living is the perfect destination for anyone in search of beautiful and functional furniture. Be sure to check out their website at laybacklivinghome.com or check out their location in Richmond, BC. And be sure to use code IDON'TCARE for 10% off your purchase. Oh, you guys, I tell you, being a mother is a lot of work. Guess what Luna had? I'll give you 2 seconds to think in your head. I'll tell ya. So, the other day, I went to the club. We're gonna talk about that later. And before we all went, everyone met here. And we were all, you know, pre-drinking downstairs here. And I brought Luna's toy, but like it had a safety pin attached to it because it was broken. And I guess when she was playing with it down here, it came off. And I knew it came off. And I was looking everywhere for the safety pin because I was like, I can't have my child, Luna, put the safety pin in her mouth. But I could not find it, so I gave up. That motherfucker had that fucking safety pin in her mouth right now. And I'm out of breath because I had to force her upstairs. And when she came upstairs, she left it down here. So then my brother came down here while I trapped her. And then we got it. And now she's not allowed down here as I record the rest of the podcast because it's been less than 10 minutes. And I got mad at her twice for grabbing things she shouldn't grab, as if we didn't bring toys down here for her to play with. while I work. So now she's upstairs. As I was saying, at least I think this is what I was saying, when I have the power to do the things I want to do in such a way I want to do them, or have the result be the way that I want the result to be, like when the decisions are mine and the power is in my hands, fantastic. That is great for me. But when it's more collaborative or really someone else's say and I'm just kind of giving input or giving a suggestion that I feel might be best, it's not my decisions at the end of the day, not mine solo at least. And the end result, whatever it may be, can't or probably won't be exactly the way I would have wanted it to be. Doesn't mean that it's worse off. Yeah, to me. I mean, if things can't be exactly how I want them to be, yeah, it's kind of worse off. But is it actually? Maybe. I don't know. Personally, yeah. But maybe not. So there is power in being able to let go and be free with it. So that's what this is saying, is sometimes letting go is the best way to free yourself. I try to do this as much as possible now, because it has been quite debilitating in terms of just like the littlest things. The volume could never be anything but ending in a 5 or a 0. Now I'm trying to let loose with that because I can't control other people to always have the volume at a number that is comfortable for me. So I've been working on it, and this sounds so stupid, but I have been working on this every single day. When I adjust the volume, I'm purposely leaving it on like a 23 or a 47, something that bothers me so much. But I'm like, at the end of the day, Alexia, this does not fucking matter. And one day, you might be living with people who want the volume at a 51. And you cannot argue with them to put it at 50, because it's not worth your energy and your time. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. You shouldn't care. So this is like, that is me sort of letting loose, not letting loose, but letting something go so I can be more free. And I know that sounds so silly because it is such a small thing, but it just starts with something small. And it escalates, or it's just proof to myself that, look, you didn't die. You didn't have a heart attack because the volume wasn't at the number you would prefer it to be at. You are okay. And that is just good proof and a good exercise, if you will, for me to be more free. Now, does it bother me for a while? Yeah, it does. Like when I put it out of the 32 or whatever, I'm thinking about it for a little while after. But guess what? Then I forget. And it's okay. And I'm okay. And, you know, with the job I have, there is lots of letting go. I created a really nice plan for the 10 weeks that the term was. And if we had stuck with it, it would have been really fun and things would have been amazing. But we didn't. Why? Because it just wasn't possible. With the kids that I had, there was no room for following a structure. It had to be a day by day, a minute by minute sort of thing, which is not what I'm used to. I'm very much used to, here's the plan, let's stick with the plan, and all will be well. But if we did stick with the plan exactly, all wouldn't have been well. they would have maybe had more fun because we would have played more games, but they wouldn't have gotten the work that we needed to get done, and they wouldn't have been able to create a little movie that they're proud of and that they're excited to show their parents and family. So being able to let things go more has or can make you more free-spirited. Though I wouldn't say I was free-spirited. I was very stressed out because I was like, guys, we got things we need to get done. But I was able to do it. I was able to be like, you know what? Screw the plan. We can't do the plan. Plan's gone. Plan B, go with the flow. And it worked out. And that's the thing, is when you let go and you prove to yourself that you are okay if things aren't going the way you wanted it to go or how you thought it might go or whatnot, that you are okay. And that at the end of the day, all is well. And if you had a plan for something and for whatever reason it couldn't be accomplished exactly the way you wanted it to, I guess it's a good time to reflect. If you have an example that's fresh on your mind, did it go worse? Did it go better? Was your point still made? Did you feel at a loss? Or did you feel more free? I guess it's a good time to like dissect whatever it is and decide like, if that were to happen again, I'd be okay. Or if that were to happen again, I'd lose my fucking mind. But I'm not high maintenance. Now some people might laugh and be like, Alexia, yeah, you are. Sure, with my skincare, 100%. With my shoes, 1,000%. With certain things, for sure. But to say I'm a high maintenance person just isn't true. Like, I don't give a shit most of the time what I look like. I don't have, I don't need my nails done. I don't need makeup on. I don't need the nicest clothes unless I'm going out and I need to dress up for that. For the most part, I just want to be in my sweats or something comfortable. I don't like fancy food or fancy jewelry or fancy anything. I don't like talking to people, and I think high maintenance people do because they want to be like the center of attention. And I want to be the center of attention on my podcast, and one day, hopefully, you know, as a character or multiple characters, the center of attention of a show or a movie, or many shows, many movies. But I don't need all that attention on me, because why? It's a lot of pressure. So I'm not a high maintenance person, but there are people who are extremely high maintenance. And let's be clear, they're fucking the worst. They're annoying as fuck. I can't stand them. They're very particular in their ways, as am I. But I think the biggest difference between people who are particular with their ways and high maintenance is that high maintenance is a choice. You're choosing to let certain things bother you and affect you. And, you know, if you're high maintenance and your outfit isn't the way you want it to look, then that's because you're choosing to let it bother you. But if you are someone with, like, anxiety about certain changes or things not being the way you want it, it's not a choice. It's the way your body runs. You get what I'm putting down? I'm not one, I'm the other. But the people who are high maintenance drive me insane. Because then you'll have a conversation with them and they're like, oh my God, I totally get what you mean. Like, I'm the same way. And it's like, no, you're not the same way. Because you're annoyed about something so trivial. And maybe so am I. I am, because the volume is the most trivial thing that could possibly bother me. But it's just different because... Whatever. I don't know what I'm trying to say. It's just like we choose the path of life that we live. So why not choose the one and work towards freedom in a way that maybe we never thought about it before? And I'll leave it there. Because, guys, sometimes giving the advice can spiral me into something not so nice. So I'm not going to complete what I was saying. Not because it's not nice. It's just I don't know how to say it in a way that is effective. So I'm just not going to say it at all. What a nice advice segment again. My favorite time of the day for the episodes, because I just sound so damn smart sometimes. Even if I'm saying the most bullshitty bullshit, which I usually don't, I still sound smart. Like, I think if I were an 80-year-old person answering the questions the way that I answer them now, like, social media accounts would take the clip and, like, put... like heartfelt music in the background and be like, words of wisdom, we should all live by this. She would know because she's lived life 80 years. She has the experience and wisdom that we should all be listening to and following. And I just, because I don't have the years to back me up, doesn't mean that I know nothing. Also, maybe I was someone in my past life who... been through shit, and the advice that I have now is passed down to me from whoever I was in my past life. Do you guys believe in past lives? I think I do and I don't. The thing with me is I like the idea of a lot of things, and it doesn't hurt me to believe in reincarnation. It doesn't hurt me to believe in the universe, aliens, and whatnot. I believe with my whole heart that aliens exist. Just it doesn't make sense any other way. But I'm also able to believe in the reincarnation. I don't believe in God, but I still believe in ghosts and the afterlife, but not necessarily in the way that we've been trained to know. But I do believe, like, when you die, your spirits have to go somewhere. And maybe not everyone gets reincarnated, but your spirit still has to go somewhere. So, I don't know. But we could also be, you know, being controlled by aliens. What the fuck do I know? What the fuck do you know? It's fun. Everyone believes in what they believe in, which is really amazing. And lots of people take it very, very serious. You know, religion, to many people, most people, is very important. More important than their life itself. Which just isn't for me. Not saying that it's bad at all, I'm not. I think it's a beautiful thing. I think it's important for lots of people to have something that they know is bigger than them. It keeps people humble. It keeps people appreciative and grateful. And it doesn't hurt. unless it does, because there are people who do take everything way too far, and it does get turned into sort of more cult vibes than anything, or people who use religion to weaponize other people, and that's not okay. The people who say, well, the Bible says this, so I have to hate you. Or the Bible says that we cannot love you anymore because of who you are. That is when I think religion is wrong and bad. Not a wrong choice, but just taken too far. You can believe in whatever you want to believe in, but still love and support and accept the people around you. And I think there's certain things that can be contradicting in the Bible. I mean, doesn't it say love all? And those same people hate people of color, hate people a part of the LGBTQ2S+ community. So it's just contradicting, which is fine. Well, it's not always fine. It's not fine when there's actions towards it. Do you guys get what I'm saying? Like, religion is a beautiful thing, but when taken too far, it is a dangerous thing. And that can be with anything. Just like if I believed so much in the universe, I believe in it entirely, but if I believed so, so much into it that I was like, I don't even know what something that could be bad towards the universe. I don't know. I don't really have an example for what I was trying to say. There's just good and bad in everything. And when things get taken too far, that's when things start to be bad. So religion is a beautiful thing when it's not taken too far and it doesn't become dangerous. Believing in aliens for me is also beautiful because it is allowing me to believe in something that is more than what Earth has to offer. If we were all so small-minded and believed that Earth was it, Earth and the sun and our solar system was it, and that there is nothing more to anything than just life on Earth, that's sad. So what, when we die, nothing happens? We go nowhere, we see nothing, nothing happens? Nobody wants to think that. No one knows for sure, but nobody wants to think of that because that's just too sad. It's important, for our species as humans to imagine all these possibilities. Because what else is there? If we just think we only have the time that we have on Earth, which we should be using very carefully, and every action should be very meaningful, because we don't have a lot of time in these bodies on this Earth. But what if it's like, here's Earth. You spend, about 80, 90 years on it. And then when you die, you're going to go to another planet. You're going to live another 80-something years maybe on there. And you're just going to live through all the planets. Maybe. Maybe we rotate. It's like a circuit, a workout circuit, but for planets and like your life. Maybe we are reincarnated, but where we lived before was somewhere else, a different planet. I don't know. It's fun and necessary for us to have those thoughts, because it makes the inevitable less terrifying, even though it's still fucking terrifying. So, let's get into my club. It wasn't even a club. So it's called the Tap House. And if you guys know anything about me, I don't like to leave my house. It's a scary world out there, and I am socially awkward and anxious. And the last time I went to a club last year, I didn't enjoy it. It wasn't fun. I mean, it was, like, I was having fun, but, like, I wasn't having fun, if that makes sense. So, for me, I got to a point where I was like, okay, you know what? Enough is enough, Alexia. It's time to go out. So, me, my best friend, my brother's girlfriend, my brother's friend, my brother's girlfriend's friends, we all went. We all went out. We came here, like I said, we had some drinks. I tried mango juice and vodka. That was fucking nasty. I don't like mango juice. I don't like juice. But I was like, mango juice, how bad could it be? It's thick. I didn't know juice could be thick. And here we are drinking mango. I couldn't finish it, so I gave it to my friend. Instead, I poured myself some Pepsi and whiskey. And that is much more of an Alexia drink. And then we hang out here for a while. Finally, at like past 10, we leave. We get an Uber and we go. We get there around 10:30-ish. We get in. I'm fucking freezing. I was wearing a lace, not a lace, a sheer bodysuit. It was like dark colors, but it was see-through, and a bra underneath with jeans. It was a cute fit. We do coat check. We get in. I get a Bellini. They had Bellinis. Instantly, I love this place. If you can provide me a drink that is a slushy, I will love you. If I had to drink just Coke and whiskey all night, I'd be annoyed. But thankfully, they had a Bellini. And they usually have pina coladas, but their blender was broken. Whatever, I guess I'll have to go back for the pina colada. But the Bellinis were amazing. Yes, they were $8. But my bestie had a gin and tonic, something like that, and it was $15. So I had the Pepsi whiskey here, and then I had two Bellinis there, and some guys came up to me and my best friend when we were at the bar. We were going to order our second Bellinis. We were waiting. And these two guys come up to us and they're like, hey. And I, like, they went up to Cassie, my bestie, first. And they're like, hey. And she's starting to talk to them. And she's like, I'm here with my best friend, Alexia. And I'm like, fuck. Hi, everyone. Hi. I hate being involved in these conversations. One thing about me is I cannot act for shit. Like, I want to have one of these conversations. I don't care if free drinks are included, okay? I do not like talking to strangers. You think I'm going to flirt with someone? Maybe if you're hot, I'll try it out. But to try to act like you care to be in a conversation that you don't want to be in with someone that you don't find attractive, there is nothing harder on the earth for me to do than that. And everyone's like, Alexia, you're an actor. I know, but I'm not a liar. I'm not a fake person. Like I'm an actor. I can put on a character. I cannot fake that I like to do something I, as Alexia, do not like to do. There's a difference. And I do not like talking to people and like having to pretend I want to flirt with you. I don't like doing it. I don't want to flirt with you. I don't want to talk to you. I don't even want to look at you. But I got a whiskey shot anyway. And was that my doing? No. That was my best friend's. She talked to them. She knew how to put on a smile. She knew how to flirt. And she wasn't flirting at all. She was just answering their questions. They're like, where do you go to school? She's like, oh, like, SFU. And they're like, oh, wow. And then she goes, Alexia, she's an actor. And I'm just like, yes. Why the fuck are you telling them everything about me? Yes, I am. And they're like, oh, my God, that's so cool. You've been in any movies? And I'm like, yeah, but we're on strike. You're on strike? Oh, my God. Yeah. It's been a tough year. So, like, why are you on strike? AI, huh? Yeah, AI would be a big thing to go on strike for. Yeah, that's why we're on strike. Okay, so what do you do? Because they bought drinks. I felt like I had to at least ask one question. Oh, what were they? Engineers or mechanics or some shit. We just had our work party in the hotel. We have two rooms tonight. That's good for you. I don't fucking care that you have two rooms tonight. I'm it's good for you. I don't care. Go away. I whisper into my best friend's ear. I'm like, how do we get rid of them? Right? They bought us a drink. I was nice for a little bit. How do we now get rid of them? Because we're still in the line. Because at the end of the day, Cassie and I didn't get our Bellinis yet. And we are still waiting for our Bellinis. And so we talked to them a little bit more. And like, I hate this. I do believe it is the thing I hate the most in life. Is this. Finally, Cassie's like, oh, we're going to go meet up with our group now. Thank you guys so much. And I'm like, oh, thank you for doing that. Thank you for getting rid of us. Next time, don't fucking bring me involved. Pretend I'm a stranger. That's just standing way too close to you. Okay, you'll get the drink. That's good for you, but I don't like doing it. That was the second time two guys came up to us. The first time was, so like I said, Francesco, my brother, was there. He, like, pushed all of us onto the dance floor. He's like, come on, let's go on the dance floor, let's dance. So we're on the dance floor, and Cassie and I are awkwardly dancing with each other. I couldn't be more awkward. This is just not my scene, but I'm having a really good time. I'm really enjoying myself because I'm around people that I know and feel very safe with. I mean, I couldn't feel more safe with anyone than my brother being there. So I felt like I could relax and unwind to my best ability, even though I was anxious. So we're on the dance floor. And then look at who decided to show up. Come here. Jump, Luna. So we're on the dance floor. And then these two other guys come up to Cassie and I. And this one guy asks me, like, where are you from? And I'm like, here. And he's like, you can't just be Canadian. I was like, no, like, I'm Italian. He goes, oh, you speak Italian? No. So you're fake Italian then? No, I'm not a fake Italian. He goes, well, I'm really close. I'm from Lebanon. I go, that's good. That's nice. And then I just turned around. Like, where do we go from there? Like, I don't actually give a shit where you're from or what you do or who you are. Because I'm not here to look for a guy. I'm here to just vibe with my friends. And we weren't at the bar. So it was like, are you going to walk me to the bar and get me a drink? No, you're not. So let's cut this shit short. I don't want to talk. Leave me alone. So I turn around and I whisper to my brother's girlfriend, I'm like, get rid of them. I don't want to talk to him. So she budges in and she's like, hey, boys, what's going on? What's happening? Who are you? And then the guy who was talking to me just walked away. And I was like, yes, thank God. But then it was awkward because I kept, like, he sat right in front of me and he kept, like, staring at me. And just naturally, I kept looking at him because he was, like, staring at me. And then we made awkward eye contact. And I'm like, dude, like, fuck off, you know? So if you see me out and about and you try to talk to me and I turn you down, don't take it personally. It's just not, it's not for me. The flirting life is not for me. The talking and pretending I care life is not for me. Not with strangers. Not with strangers. And you know what? It's honestly good for the both of us because it gets me out of these situations and it gives you time to go find someone else and hopefully be successful with them. But imagine I waste 20 minutes of your time talking and feeding into you and playing you on and pretending I like you just for me to walk away and be like, this is going nowhere. That would hurt you. Because then you put in all that work. Do you even have energy to go find another person and do all that with again? So you're welcome, actually, because I'm cutting it short. So you have the time and energy to move on. You're welcome. Now I get if that sound makes me sound like the biggest bitch on the planet. But who are we to, like, please strangers? We don't have to do that shit. You are a stranger who I've never seen in my life. I don't owe you anything. You don't owe me anything. If I don't find you attractive, what are we doing here? You know? What are we doing here? That's step one. Step one for me. So that was the only two times people came up to me. Thank God. I did see some people that I was purposely trying to avoid. And I think I did a good job. I'm short. So all I had to do, head down. Or I just had to, like, hide behind someone. Everyone was taller than me. I just had to hide behind someone and gone. Couldn't see me. I had a really good time. You know, it was chill vibes. It wasn't a nightclub. It was a restaurant that at a certain time, like, they push some of the tables away and there's a dance floor, the bar, you could still order food and stuff. So it's more of a chill vibe, which was something that I really did enjoy. And it was fun, like, because it was chill and it was fun and you weren't forced to stand and you could sit if you want, or you can just chill at the bar or go on the dance floor. Or go outside, like, because it was so fluid and it didn't feel as cramped. Like, it was fucking cramped, but not as cramped as it is in a club where you, like, you can barely get through. So I enjoyed it. I would go back. I had a jolly old time. It was a week ago. I'm filming this on Friday the 15th. Come, jump, jump, Luna, come. Here. Yeah, my baby. I'm filming this on the 15th and I went last Friday. And I looked good and I had fun and we came home early. And was I hungover the next day? Absolutely not. Was I even drunk that night? No. Which I was actually pissed about. I wasn't even tipsy. I felt normal. Which I'm like, if I paid for two drinks and got a free whiskey shot and had whiskey and Pepsi before we left, I should be feeling at least a little bit of something. I was pissed. I was pissed about it. I didn't spend $20 on drinks to not feel nothing. Right? Oh man, you guys. Fun times. It's important for me to do things like that as often as I can build the confidence to do it, because I am 20. Your 20s are the time when you're meant to do these things. you can do them in your 30s, but they start to feel a little different and whatnot. I don't want to waste my time. I'm very mindful of my time. I'm very meaningful with the things that I know I want to do and will do and have done. It's very clear to me that life is precious. And because I know all of these things, that is why I feel so comfortable and confident, really, to follow my heart and to reach for my dreams, to do the things that are more scary. And a part of that is going out. And even if it's once a year that I gain the balls to do it, then that's once a year that I do it. And thank God for it. But you know what? I could do the tap house more often. Not every week. I'm not one of those. But maybe like every 4 months, I could do it. And then it's like special. Oh, Alexi is here. No one would care. Okay, you guys, thank you so much for tuning in to the fun life updates. I know they've been more dark than anyone would like, but there's always light even in the darkness. And if I could be the light, then fuck yeah. Bye.